Hello everyone. Welcome to Learning Management System, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. Myself, Sridhar Murthy, Selection Grade Lecturer, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Government Polytechnic, Chikmagalur. In today's session, we are going to learn the construction of alternator and also salient pole type rotor of session number 29 of unit 4. Belongs to DC machines and alternator of third semester. Before going into the today's session, we will recall what we have discussed in the previous session, that is in session number 28. In session number 28, we learned the principle of operation of alternator. So in that, we have learned the definition of alternator and also the principle of operation of alternator. Here, in order to understand the principle of operation of alternator, we have considered a simple loop generator in which a single rectangular coil is made to rotate in a uniform magnetic field. And in each rotation of the single turn coil in a uniform magnetic field, we have observed how the induced voltage is varied or varies. So by understanding the simple loop generator, we can learn or we have learned the principle of operation of alternator. So in today's session, we mainly concentrates on the construction of alternator and the salient pole type rotors of session number 29. Let us see the topics belongs to this session. They are the construction of alternator. Here we are going to see the constructional details of the alternator and also we are going to learn what is meant by stator, what is its function, and the next one, the rotor, what is the function of the rotor, and then the salient pole type rotor. The rest of the constructional details of the alternators are studied in session number 30. So in this session, we mainly concentrate on these four topics. Okay, the construction of alternator. Consider the diagram shown here. So this is a detailed labeled diagram of a three-phase alternator. So whatever the parts labeled over here have been broadly classified into three groups: the stationary part, the rotating part, and the exciter. So that's what mentioned here. So it basically consists of a stator, which is nothing but a stationary part, a rotor, which is nothing but a rotating part, and next one, the exciter. Now let us understand the each part in detail, okay? The first one. See, as I told you, the construction of an alternator is very similar to that of a DC generator. But constructionally, the major difference between a DC generator and an alternator is that in case of a DC generator, the armature winding is a rotating one, whereas the magnetic system or the field system is a stationary. But in case of an alternator, the armature winding is a stationary, whereas the field winding is a rotating one. So this is the main constructional difference between a DC generator and an alternator. And this has been studied in session number 27. Okay. Now let us say take the stator. As the name suggests or the name implies, stator is nothing but the stationary part of the alternator. As I told you, the stationary part of the alternator is nothing but the armature which is having the conductors in it. Okay. So see this diagram. So this is the diagram of a stator. See, observe on the inner periphery of the stator, the slots are provided, and these inner periphery of the stator is made up of thin sheet of silicon steel. It is made up of a thin sheet of silicon steel. Why? Because silicon is used because it is having a very low or least hysteresis loss, and are laminated, thin sheet of laminations. Why? Because to reduce loss due to eddy current. Okay. So as I told you, on the inner periphery of the stator, the slots are provided, In these slots, the three-phase winding is placed, and the three-phase winding is usually star connected. Why it is star connected? That will be seen later. Okay. See now, observe here. For large capacity machines, the inner periphery of the slots are laminated and are slotted. Okay. But in case of a small capacity machines, these inner slots, okay, these inner slots are fabricated during the mold itself. Okay. Now, observe here. As the name suggests, as I told you, the stator is a stationary part, and it is made up of a special magnetic material. So it is made up of a special magnetic material which can allow high magnetic permeability and a low magnetic hysteresis loss. So in order to have a high magnetic permeability and a low hysteresis loss, it is made up of a special magnetic material called as a fabricated silicon steel. But for small capacity machines, it is made up of a cast iron instead of silicon steel. And as I told you, these slots are laminated, thin sheet of laminations to avoid loss due to eddy current. Okay. Now, the state continuation, the slots are provided in the inner periphery of the core, and the armature conductors or the coils are assembled in it. Okay. And already I told you, the armature winding of an alternator is usually a three-phase winding and are connected in star, and its neutral is connected to the ground. Now here the question raises, why the stator of an alternator is star connected only? Why not is it is delta? Let us see. We will recall the basic concept, that is the relationship between the line voltage and the phase voltage in case of a star connection. So in case of a star connection, the phase voltage, E phase, the phase voltage is given by line voltage divided by root 3. Or else I can say 1 by root 3 is nothing but 0.577 times the line voltage. That means phase voltage is just 57.7% of the line voltage. That means the voltage stress in the conductors of the stator slots is less compared to the line voltage. Hence, for this is the great advantage of having a star connection. Suppose on the other hand, suppose if imagine in the phase of the conductors, in each conductors are in the phase voltage of a stator conductor is around 100 volts. Okay, is around 100 volts. Then what is the line voltage? Line voltage is equal to 100 divided by root 3 or 0.577, which is around 173. For every 100 volts of the phase voltage, for every 100 volts of the phase voltage, we get the line voltage equal to around approximately 173 volts. So this is the greatest advantage of having a star connection. So this is the first advantage. This is the first advantage. Second advantage of having a star connection is that in case of a star connection, we get star point. See, this is the star connection. Okay. So this is a star connection. So in case of a star connection, we have the facility of a neutral. What is the advantage of having a neutral in the stator conductors? This, if we earth this neutral to the ground, okay, if we connect this neutral point to the ground, what is the advantage? The advantage is that if there is any circulating current due to unbalanced load, this circulating current will flow to the ground. Hence, the load will be balanced. So this is the a greatest another advantage. Okay, so because of these two points, always the stator winding, the three-phase stator winding is always a star connected. So because of these two advantages. So what is the first advantage? The phase voltage is lesser than the line voltage. Hence, the phase voltage or the conductor's phase are less stressed. And the second advantage is that because of the neutral facility, the load will be balanced and we can provide easy path for the circulating current. So because of this advantage, always the stator of alternator is star connected only. Okay, after this, next move on to the rotor. As the name implies, a rotor is a rotating part of an alternator, which is nothing but a magnetic system or the pole system. Okay, the revolving field structure of the electrical machine is called as the rotor of a synchronous generator. The rotor carries the field windings. As I told you, rotor is nothing but a rotating magnetic field. So it carries the field winding, and this field winding is supplied by the DC source, which is called as the excitation. Okay. Next, as I told you, the excitation is nothing but a DC source, and this DC source is called as the exciter, which is generally a small DC shunt or a compound generator, which is mounted on the same shaft of the alternator. That means on the same shaft of the alternator, a small DC shunt generator is placed, which will supply a constant DC voltage to the field system of the alternator, which is nothing but the rotor. Okay. Basically, there are two types of rotor constructions, very important from the examination point of view. Basically, there are two types of rotor constructions. What are those two types of rotor constructions? First one is salient pole type rotor, and the second one is smooth cylindrical type rotor. So as I told you, the first one is salient pole type rotor, and the second one is smooth cylindrical type rotor. This smooth cylindrical type rotor is also called as non-salient pole type rotor. Let us take the first one, salient pole type rotor. The smooth cylindrical type rotor will be discussed in the next session, that is in session number 30. Okay, let us take the first one, salient pole type rotor. So this is the constructional details of a salient pole type rotor. Observe here, the salient poles. See, it is called salient poles. Why? Because salient pole type rotor, because the poles are projecting outwards. See, so this is the drum, magnetic drum. From that the drum, the poles are projected outward. Hence, it is called as a salient pole type rotor. The main characteristics of salient pole type rotor is that it is having a large diameter and a short axial length. Okay, short axial length. So this is the main characteristics of a salient pole type rotor. See, the poles are projecting outward, and on the course of these poles, so this is the core of the pole. Okay, this is the core of the pole. On these cores, the field winding are placed. Okay, on these core, the field winding are placed. These field windings are connected in series. Observe here carefully. These windings are connected in series such that when the DC current passes through it, listen carefully, these field windings placed on the core of the salient pole are connected in series, and they are connected such that when the DC current passes through it, the flux produced will be such that if this is south pole, then the adjacent pole will become a north pole. Like that, the field winding is excited. As I told you in the previous slide, these field windings are excited by a DC shunt generator, which is mounted on the same shaft of the alternator. Okay. As I told you, such generators are characterized by their large diameter and short axial length. It is having a, see, observe here, it is having a large axial length. So the diameter of the rotor is large compared to its axial length. That means it is having a short axial length and a large diameter. Okay. Next. The poles are made up of, see, these poles are made up of thin sheet of silicon steel. So it is made up of a silicon steel, to reduce loss due to hysteresis, and they are made up of thin sheet of laminations. Why? Because to reduce loss due to eddy current. Okay, and these salient poles are attached to the drum, magnetic drum, heavy magnetic drum, with the help of a dowel joint. What is meant by a dowel joint? That is shown in the next slide. In salient pole type rotor, the poles are always projected outward direction as shown in the figure. Now observe here, as I told you, these salient poles are connected to the drum with the help of a dowel joint. So this is called as the dowel joint. So this is the dowel joint, and these are the holes, and these the pole show. It is called as the pole show. Okay, so this is called as pole show. On these pole shows, damper windings are provided. Damper windings are provided. Okay, what is the function of the damper winding? The function of the damper winding. So in detail, the damper windings are learnt in the next sessions. Okay, so here as a point of interest, I am telling that the main function of the damper winding is to avoid the momentary speed fluctuations. So because of its large diameter, as the load on the alternator changes, the alternator will rotate with oscillations. Okay, with oscillations it rotates, and these oscillations are called as momentary speed fluctuations. In order to avoid these, some damper windings are provided in the slots of the pole show. Okay, so this is around point, so this one sheet which is around 0.3 to 0.5 mm of thickness. Okay, so how it is connected to the drum, it is shown in this diagram also. Okay, see, observe here. So this a small pole is connected to this drum with the help of a dowel joint. That means in this pole, the dowel joint is projected outward, whereas in the drum, the slots are cut on inner section. So in this inner section, this joint has been placed firmly. So this type of fixing is called as dowel joint. Okay, so this is regarding the salient pole type rotor. Okay, now, see, as I told you, the field windings of the salient pole type rotor are connected in series such a way that when the field winding is energized, then adjacent poles will have an opposite polarity, north pole and south poles. So in order to reduce the effect of hunting, which is called as the momentary speed fluctuations, the momentary speed fluctuations of the salient poles is due to when there is a sudden fluctuations of the load, the alternator rotor will rotates in oscillations, so which is called as an hunting. So in order to avoid this hunting, damper windings are provided in the poles faces. Okay, next. So it is used to, so such type of rotors, very important, such type of salient pole type rotors are used for low and medium speed engines driven alternators, particularly in hydroelectric power plants. So in hydroelectric power plants, the speed of the alternator is very less, so hence in order to compensate this less speed, we are increasing the number of poles just by using the salient poles. So why the salient poles rotors are limited to low speed only? Because of they are having a large diameters. Because of their large diameter, the speed of rotation is restricted. Hence such type of rotors are used only for low and medium speed alternators, that is 120 to 400 rpm. Okay, that means for high speed alternators, such type of rotors are not used. See, usually the ratings of such salient pole rotor is less than 500 kilowatts. Okay, is less than 500 kilowatts. So these are the some of the points regarding today's session. So once again, we will quickly recall what we have discussed in this session. Is in this session we have seen the construction of the alternator. In the construction of the alternator, we have seen the various parts, and all these various parts have been classified into three major groups, that is a stator, rotor, and exciter. So in this session, we mainly concentrated on the stator and rotor. As I told you, the rotor has been divided into classified into two types: salient pole type rotor and smooth cylindrical type rotor. So in salient pole type rotor, the main characteristics of salient pole type rotor, it is having a large diameter, and it is having a projected pole type rotors, and it is having a short axial length. So these are the things that we have learned in these sessions. The smooth cylindrical rotors and also the exciter will be learned in the next sessions. Let us see some of the important multiple choice questions based on today's session. Are the first one: practically, most of the alternators prefer which type of construction? What type of construction we are using? Let us see what are the options: rotating field type, rotating armature type, both are equally important, none of these. See, the important point for this question is, logic to solve this question is that, so usually alternator, the basic difference between alternator and a DC generator is that in case of a DC generator, the armature is a rotating one, the field is stationary. But whereas in case of an alternator, the armature is stationary and the magnetic system is a rotating one. Okay, so what are the advantages of this? That will be learned in the next sessions. Okay, so then which is the right answer? The right answer is the rotating field type. Rotating field type, observe here, the answer is rotating field type. So usually a rotating field system type alternators are preferred. Next, the armature winding of an alternator, options: delta star connected, generally delta connected, star delta connected, always star connected. As I told you in one of the slide, today's slide, it is always star connected. Why? Because the phase voltage is equal to root 3 divided by line voltage divided by root 3, or else E phase is equal to just 0.577 times the line voltage. Hence the phase voltage is not stressed. That means for every 100 volts of the phase voltage, the line voltage becomes what? Root 3 times. Or else the line voltage is equal to what? Root 3 times the phase voltage. Hence, for a small voltage, small phase voltage, we have a large line voltage. This is the one advantage. What is the another advantage? Just we are recalling, the another advantage is we are having a neutral facility in star connection. That facility is not available in delta connection. Because of this neutral, we can ground so that we can balance the load, or we can provide a path for the circulating current. So because of this, winding of a alternator is always star connected. So always star connected. Next question: in salient pole type rotors, observe here, the first option is the poles are projected out from the surface of the rotor. The unslotted portions of the cylinder itself acts as the poles, both A and B, none of the above. As I told you, salient pole type rotor are characterized by large diameter and short axial length. Why it is having a large axial, large diameter? Because of this. Okay, because it is having a projected, the poles are projected outward. The poles are projected outward, hence it is having a large diameter. So the answer is the poles are projected out. The next question: separate damper winding is necessary in which type of rotor? Smooth cylindrical type rotor, salient pole type rotor, both A and B, none of these. Still, we have not learnt about, discussed about a smooth cylindrical type rotor. So, obviously, the damper winding is a most important thing in case of a salient pole type rotor. Why we need damper windings? The damper windings are used to avoid hunting. Okay, that is the momentary speed fluctuations. In order to avoid the momentary speed fluctuations, we are going to use the damper windings. Okay, so the answer is salient pole type rotors. Okay, next question. The air gap in a salient pole machine, maximum at the center of the poles, least at the center of the poles, and increases while moving away from the center, maximum at the center and decreases while moving away from the center, equally distributed. The hint for this question is, let us try to recall the shape of the salient pole type rotor. So it is somewhat like this. Okay, the salient pole type rotor is like this. That means if this is the stator, if this is the stator, observe here, at the center the air gap is very minimum. Why? Because it is being chamfered like this. Okay, it is having this shape, curved shape. At the center of the pole, the air gap is very less, and as we move away from the center of the pole, the air gap is more. Okay, we are having a more air gap. So hence, the answer is least at the center of the poles and increases while moving away from the center. So that is the answer. The hint for this answer is, imagine or try to recall the shape of the salient pole. Okay. The next one, the diameter and axial length of the rotors of a salient pole type rotors are, the diameter and axial length of the rotor of a salient pole type rotor are small diameter, small axial length, large diameter, large axial length, large diameter, small axial length, small diameter, large axial length. So, as I told, one of the most important characteristics of a salient pole type rotor is that it is having a large diameter and small axial length. So that is the one of the important characteristics of the salient pole type rotor. That means the option C, large diameter and small axial length. Why it is having a large diameter? Because of the poles are projected outward. Large diameter, small axial length. So students, these are the some of the important questions related to today's session. So this is the reference material for today's class, and this is our state LMS team, belongs to the subject DC machines and alternators. I hope you have all enjoyed this LMS session. Wish you a very happy learning management system. Thank you. Thank you one and all.